हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मी सौरभ अवस्थी, इंग्लिश टीचर ऑफ माउंट लिट्रा जी स्कूल झांसी। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द चैप्टर फ्रॉम बी हाइव ऑफ क्लास 9, द बॉन्ड ऑफ लव, रिटन बाय केनेथ एंडरसन। सो हियर दिस इज़ द 9th चैप्टर ऑफ बी हाइव विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल सी दैट अ स्लॉथ बेयर whose name is Bruno, which has been given to him by the owner, that was the wife of the narrator. So here we are going to see and study about the life of this animal who is actually dangerous for the society, but here one of the family has taken care of this animal and then kept it in their home. So let's study about the summary of this chapter now. Here the author got their pet sloth bear Bruno by accident. Actually 2 years before, he and his companions were traveling through the sugarcane fields of Mysore. They saw people driving away wild pigs. Suddenly a big sloth bear came charging out on the field. One of his friends panicked and shot the bear. As they watched the animal fall, they saw something move on its back. To everyone's surprise, they realized that it was a baby sloth bear. The little bear cried pitifully over his mother's body. When it started running, the narrator chased after the baby and was able to capture it. He put it in a bag and presented it to his wife. Now, the wife was very happy. His wife was delighted. She put a colored ribbon around his neck and called him Bruno. Bruno started drinking milk from a bottle and he was very happy at that time because now he have got a new home. Then he started eating and drinking everything from porridge to curry to pudding to tea and also buttermilk. Bruno became attached to their Alsatian dogs and the tenants' children. He was enjoying. As a kid, he spent his time in playing, running around the kitchen and sleeping in the author's bed. One day, Bruno had an accident. Now, something was going to be changed in his life. Let's see what it is. The author had put down poison for rats in his library to kill the rats. But that day, Bruno entered the library and ate some of the poison. The author rushed Bruno to the veterinary doctor. They were very afraid. The doctor found an antidote for Bruno. Bruno was cured and the narrator took him back home. Bruno had by now grown many times in size, but he was sweet, mischievous and playful. He was fond of everyone. His wife changed Bruno's name to Baba, which means a small boy. She taught him tricks like boxing, holding a stick as gun and holding a stump of wood in his hands. Baba was growing into a fearsome creature. The tenant's children feared him and he was kept chained most of the time. The author's friends advised them to send Baba to the zoo. The narrator and his son agreed with them because they were also afraid that it may not hurt someone. Though his wife protested, they managed to convince her to send Baba to a zoo in Mysore. Though the narrator missed Baba, he was relieved that he was gone to a proper place. His wife, however, was inconsolable. because she was not ready to understand the situation. She wept and refused meals. So now the family was worried. She wrote letters to the curator of the zoo asking after Baba, and it seemed that Baba was not doing well either. Now the curator gave the reply, and he told in the letter that he was refusing food too. This shows that Baba was not happy and he was not having food also. This means somewhere he was not able to forget the wife of the narrator. So they asked their friends visiting Mysore to check on Baba, that how he is over there in the zoo. So now they also reported that Baba had grown thin and unhealthy. Finally, his wife convinced the author to go and see the Baba. Their friends thought that Baba would not recognize them and advised them to be prepared. But Baba howled with happiness when he saw the author's wife. The wife ran up to Baba and patted him to the bars. She would not leave the cage now. She stayed by Baba's cage and fed him food. When the closing time came, Baba and his wife cried bitterly. The wife tearfully asked the curator to take Baba back with her. The curator told her to get permission from the superintendent who lived in Bangalore. So the author and his wife went to Bangalore. The superintendent was a kind-hearted man and agreed to let Baba go back home with them. His wife was overjoyed. The author engaged coolies to create a special island. A stream of water surrounded the island and separated it from the main building. A wooden box was installed for Baba to sleep in. Then Baba was released into his new home. His wife and Baba were both delighted at the reunion. What the narrator is trying to say here is that love and affection do not only belong to human beings, but Baba with his affection and memory proved that he is as sensitive as human beings. The narrator also emphasizes on the strength of the bond between his wife and the sloth bear Baba. So this was the story about the bond and the love between human beings and animals. So here we end the story with the moral that we should learn to live happily with humans as well as with animals, and we should learn to love all. Thank you so much. Now we will meet again with the new chapter in the new video. Till then, thank you so much. Take care, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you so much.